And welcome back. This is your man, Warrior. This is another patron roster review. This is Tobi One Kenobi. He is from, and I'm going to totally butcher this, I'm sorry, but Division Polska, that is Division Poland, is what it actually is. I know I probably butchered that, but I wanted to try my best anyway. Now, Tobi One knows really what he's doing. His arena team, he's getting number one every day. Got a phenomenal team. Basically, it's a hybrid of the Tide team that I often suggest. It's where you have Jedi training Rey with the two droids, Old Ben, and then because he does not have General Kenobi ready to go, he has Thrawn as a backup, which is phenomenal. Also, in Fleet Arena, getting easily top 20 every day, using the exact ships that I would highly suggest. Obviously, you're going to want to continue to develop both the ships and their pilots, and so you want to continue to gear up them and get their abilities up. That will maximize the abilities of the ship. And you didn't have a whole lot. You just wanted me to look at your arena team and see if there was something there that maybe you could tweak or change. And I went through all your mods, and you are actually doing very, very well with your modding. You also wanted to know about Zetas. So let's go look at your inventory. So Tobi One, for being a dolphin, for playing just over a year, you're doing really, really well. I know you're a small dolphin, you don't spend a ton, but you have focused what little bit of energy into the right characters. Definitely Jedi Training Rey, Commander Luke, R2-D2, BB-8, Grand Admiral Thrawn. We're talking about all of the greatest of the greats, and you have them gear 12, so excellent. When I look at your team, though, I'm really looking for Zetas, because you talked about dark side territory battles being important, territory wars being important, and basically being able to possibly change things up in arena. So what I am looking for in Zetas is leadership abilities. Now, you mentioned you wanted to Zeta General Veers. And so I went to your Imperial Troopers and I looked at him, and I do recommend General Veers and his Zeta, but not yet. We're going to put your General Veers on hold, which is exactly what you were wanting me to know, or wanting me to tell you, is should you pause General Veers for another individual? And so we're going to go ahead and pause him. He can be second on your Zeta priority list, but these guys need developed further, which I know you're currently working on, before this Zeta really becomes critical. Let's look at who you should Zeta first. That's right, Emperor Palpatine. And I know that uniques are always capable of being utilized on any team, but you're going to need more dark side leaders. And Emperor Palpatine obviously just got reworked. So my 2 cents on the very next Zeta that you should use would be on the leadership ability of Emperor Palpatine. This will give you just one additional leader, and this is a really good rework. Now, of course, you want to continue the Imperial Troopers, and they're the number one priority. And that was the last thing you asked me about, was priority for dark side territory battles. You really wanted to know, you know, one or two or three teams you should focus on for that. And you know, right now you're focused on Imperial Troopers. So after your Imperial Troopers, the next team you will want to focus on for dark side territory battles will be Night Sisters. Now, the good news is you have a little bit of time with the Imperial Troopers before they're done. Hopefully, by the time you finish your Imperial Troopers, Mother Talzin and the zombie will finally have a spot on the board. They did say they were going to make them farmable very soon on the board. And so, like I said, in a couple of months, when you finish with your Imperial Troopers, you should be able to then focus on the Night Sisters without any fear of having to spend crystals on these characters. The two most important would be Mother Talzin and Zombie. Those two really have to be on a Night Sister squad. Obviously, Asajj and Aldaka are also excellent Night Sisters and should make their way to the team. If when you get these characters and you start to level them up, the Night Sister spirit is farmable, then that is actually the one that I would focus on over the Night Sister Initiate or Talia or any of those. But if the Night Sister spirit isn't farmable yet, then you can focus on one of the others. For the last team, you will have to focus on bounty hunters, and the only bounty hunter you really probably should add to this is going to be Zam Wessel. Zam is going to help a tremendous amount. She gets a lot of extra turn meter, and she can blow off all of Greedo's detonators. And Greedo and Zam work really, really well against the Wampas in the special missions. And so make sure that you focus on your bounty hunters. Obviously, this is turn three or team three that you're going to focus on. So get those Imperial Troopers, then the Night Sisters, then the bounty hunters. So yes, I looked at your arena, Tobi One. You look like you're doing a phenomenal job in both. Your Zetas, you've really got a great idea moving to Emperor Palpatine instead of Veers, since Veers isn't quite ready. And for Dark Side Territory battles, we know you definitely want to finish off those Imperial Troopers. Go to your Night Sisters because they should be farmable by that time. And then go to Bounty Hunters. Your Empire already look really good. Again, Division Poland, shout out to you guys. Tobi One, hit me up if you have any questions. Anyone else, leave comments down below and keep your gaming on. Warrior out.